Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. Astrophysicists using the Submillimeter Array Telescope have made an astonishing discovery on the formation of stars. The scientists obtained the most detailed images yet of a stellar nursery within the Snake Nebula. What they have discovered is not what they expected. In two designated regions of the nebula, the scientists detected a total of 23 so-called cosmic seeds, glowing regions that will eventually give birth to stars. The team reports that the average cosmic seed weighs only between 5 and 25 times the mass of the Sun, far less than the standard model had predicted. A press release from the Harvard-Smithsonian Center for Astrophysics reads, "Previous theories proposed that high-mass stars form within massive isolated cores weighing at least 100 times the mass of the Sun. These new results show that that is not the case. The data also demonstrate that massive stars aren't born alone but in groups." The team also was surprised to find that these two nebular patches had fragmented into individual star seeds so early in the star formation process. They detected bipolar outflows and other signs of active, ongoing star formation. To understand the significance of this discovery, we look now to the predictions of the Electric Universe and plasma cosmology.
This story, how small cosmic seeds grow into big stars, is another example where plasma cosmology has already set the scene and provided the expectations of what we would discover in deep space, and now astronomers are being surprised by the findings which actually support the predictions and the expectations of the plasma cosmology view. In the original paper, it's said that massive stars form in what's called infrared dark clouds, and it's been difficult up until now to be able to find out what's going inside those clouds, because even the telescopes like the Herschel infrared telescope and various other millimeter wave radio telescopes and so on have not been able to have the resolution or the capability to see what's going on right inside these clouds. So it was decided that an interferometric system would be used, where you use a number of telescopes all looking at the same object, and then you gain the extra definition of that much expanded aperture of all of those telescopes. And the result has been in defiance of some of the expectations of the standard theories. One of the major aspects is the very fact that the stars are found forming along a filament, which is aptly called the snake. Now, it was initially thought that massive stars would form in individual protostellar clouds, and that it was the collapse of those clouds which would form the massive star. But here, instead, we find a number of stars being formed along a filament. And the filament shows that the stars themselves break up along a cylinder. Now, none of this fits what you would expect from a gravitational theory. Gravitational theory of star formation is that you have a center of mass towards which all of the surrounding material in the cloud tends to move and to congregate to eventually form the star. But here you have stars forming along a filament. What's more, they are forming much earlier than expected. In other words, the amount of material you have to draw into the center of the filament to form a star is much less than you would expect from the gravitational model. All of this is covered and explained by the plasma cosmology view, which says that you have an electric current flowing through cloudy material, rather like a lightning bolt, cloud-to-cloud lightning. The electric current flowing along that filament will draw in matter over a greater distance and with more force than gravity alone will do. The other thing is that once that material aggregates along the axis of that filament, the requirements for forming a star are not that nuclear fusion begins, but that the electric current input to those protostellar blobs, if you like, will cause them to begin heating without worrying about gravitational energy, the collapse inwards heating the gas. And in fact, the stars that are found in these filaments, the motion of the chemicals in that cloud appears to be turbulent and also associated with magnetic fields. This turbulence is often a result of a mistaken view of what's going on in the cloud. The material will be affected by the magnetic fields and the electric field of the current flowing through the cloud, And the result will be that the matter will move more rapidly than expected from a gravitational infall, and therefore you would expect more turbulence. So once again, all of the aspects that we are seeing with this groundbreaking high-definition picture of stars forming in one of these dark clouds conforms to the plasma cosmology model. Previous theories proposed that high-mass stars form within very massive isolated cores weighing at least 100 times the mass of the Sun. These new results show that that is not the case. The data also demonstrate that massive stars aren't born alone but in groups. The co-author of the paper says, high-mass stars form in villages. It's a family affair. And this is quite distinct from the expectations of gravitational collapse. The team was surprised to find that the two nebula patches within this snake had fragmented into individual star seeds so early in the star formation process. They also detected bipolar outflows and other signs of active, ongoing star formation. The very fact that we are detecting bipolar outflows doesn't match a gravitational infall model at all. But one of the aspects of the electrical nature of stars is that when a material is drawn in radially into the filament and begins to form the star, if the energy stored in the material falling in towards the star exceeds a certain amount, then it will cause protostellar jets, jets going out along the axis of the filament. And this is also what's been observed. Of course, the article finishes with, eventually the Snake Nebula will dissolve and shine as a chain of several star clusters. That's true, but the reason that it will continue to shine has nothing to do with the standard model of stars. It has everything to do with the electrical model of stars. They will continue to shine because the electric current that formed them still persists.
For continuous updates on space news from the Electric Universe, stay tuned to thunderbolts.info.